The APS is one of the absolute best hard X-ray facilities in the world. For the things we do, it's absolutely world-leading. There's the instruments we use here don't exist anywhere else.
APS, for my research, is unique because it's a high-energy source. There's only a few synchrotrons that really get into the super high-energy part of the spectrum.
This is absolutely one of the places people can do very unique work with X-rays. So a storage room-based X-rays, it's not something that you can do in the lab.
As science becomes increasingly diverse and competitive, it's important to have access to the best scientific tools available. And without the upgrade to the APS, it will become increasingly challenging to stay at the cutting edge of materials research.
The upgrade is really kind of a signal of renewal, and then you start to look at the renewal of everything. So it's a kind of renewal which is very healthy for a facility after so many years of operation, that you really have a step back and look at the things you're doing and then to decide like, no, that's, we should do it better now.
The APS upgrade is going to make a fundamental difference in the kind of science that we can do. Today we can focus with the optics that we're using at our Beamline, we can focus the X-ray beam down to a size of 1 or 2 microns. That's not small enough to study a lot of the kinds of problems we'd like to be able to study.
So when the APS upgrade is complete, I want to perform an experiment in which I break a material and I watch where every atom goes in that material.
With the APS upgrade, we'll be precisely analyze the location of those metals, including copper and zinc. And this is going to be a very important contribution to the disease pathogenesis, basically how the disease is progressing or developing.
I'm really looking forward to the APS upgrade. I think it's a fantastic project, a wonderful decision. It moves the APS to the forefront of X-ray research. I think it's going to be fantastic.
I think there's going to be a lot of experiments that are going to be possible that we haven't even begun to consider with the upgrade. And I think it's going to be a really interesting conundrum to have.